Hello everyone. In last lecture, we have started human respiratory system. So in this human respiratory system, we have completed upper respiratory system. And today we are continuing here another part, that is lower respiratory system. So lower respiratory system is consists of larynx, trachea, bronchi, bronchiole and the lungs. So these whole parts we will discuss in today's lecture. So the first one is, that is larynx. So see here, this is a diagram of larynx. In this larynx, or this larynx is also called as voice box or the Adam's apple. So this Adam's apple we found generally in male. And in male, this Adam's apple we found in at the time of puberty. So another part is, it is a respiratory tract. It is a part of respiratory tract which contains a vocal cords for the producing sound. The larynx hota hai sound produce karne saati help karta. Then it extends from the laryngopharynx, and it extends from laryngopharynx and head bone to the trachea. The head bone to the trachea parinda larynx has to extend us to. Then this trachea is a hollow and tubular in structure. Then its wall is made up of cartilage plate. And this is wall. This wall is made up of cartilage plate held by a membranes and muscles. And these cartilage are of four types. Or which we can see here, three types. So the first one is thyroid cartilage. It is the biggest cartilage and one in number. Then cricoid cartilage, it is a ring like structure, and this cartilage again here one in number. And then the third one is arytenoid cartilage. This arytenoid cartilage is a triangular in shape, and this arytenoid cartilage we found in a two in number. So these three cartilage we found inside in the this part, that is larynx. So thyroid cartilage is help for the protection of upper part of the larynx, and cricoid cartilage is help or is protection for the lower side of the cartilage. And third one is, that is arytenoid cartilage. This cartilage is help for the protection of back side of the larynx. Okay, so this larynx lined with the ciliated columnar epithelium. Then this ciliated columnar epithelium is open, or the larynx is open into a glottis. When this glottis is open, at that time vocal cord is relaxed. Vocal cord is relaxed. So see here, this like of vocal cord, and this vocal cord is made up of membrane and muscles. Then this is a glottis. This is a glottis. When the glottis is opens, at that time this vocal cord, this is a vocal cord. This is vocal cord, and this vocal cord is relaxed. And when this vocal cord is relaxed, when we inhale oxygen, at that time glottis is open more and more, and this vocal cord is relaxed. Then again, when we exhale, at that time this is contract, and this vocal cord is much bigger and bigger. So this particular vocal cord are present in male as a larger in size, but in female opening up. This opening of epiglottis is help for the prevention of entry of food to the trachea. The trachea madhe food jaane pasna epiglottis ha kay karto asto prevent karto. So this is the particular nature of larynx. So larynx is also called as a voice box or Adam's apple. So Adam's apple hi kadhi form asta at the time of puberty. Then this larynx is extend from laryngopharynx and hyoid bone to the trachea. Trachea parent to hyoid bone ani larynx madhe laryngopharynx madhe larynx extend hoto. Then it is hollow and tubular structure. This is the structure of larynx, and this larynx we found in hollow and tubular structure. So this its wall made up of cartilage plate and held by a membranes and muscles. So these cartilages are of three types. First one is hyoid cartilage, second one is Krieger cartilage, and third one is arachnoid cartilage. This arachnoid cartilage we found in a triangular shape, and this is a twin number. Then lined with the ciliated columnar epithelium. And this larynx is lined with a ciliated columnar number. So this is particular nature of larynx. Then another part one is that is trachea. So the trachea is a tubular in shape. Trachea is a tubular in shape and so the next part is that is trachea. Trachea is a long tube and its length is 10 to 12 centimeter. Then it runs through the neck in front of the esophagus and extend into and up to a thoracic cavity. So it's supported internally by a C shape and its rings is 16 to 20 rings are present, and these 16 to 20 rings of cartilage, and these rings is supported by or prevent the collapse of trachea. Then this portion is lined with a ciliated pseudo stratified epithelium and mucus gland. So this particular epithelium or muscles is held for the trapping of unwanted particles, and these unwanted particles prevention for the muscles. So this particular trachea is held for of the entry of unwanted particles to the lungs. So these are the particular nature of trachea. So see again here, this is a structure of trachea. This is long tube and 10 to 12 centimeter in length, and this particular cartilage we look like in a C shape, and this C shape portion is prevent to collapsing the trachea. Then this particular trachea is runs through a neck portion in front of the esophagus and extend into and up to the thoracic cavity. Then another one is that is bronchi. Another part is that is bronchi and bronchioles. Both these parts are included at one in particular structure. So see here, this is a bronchi, and this bronchi is attached to the trachea. So that's why trachea is divides. This trachea is divides in two parts. That is left part and the right part. So this left part and right part of the primary bronchi. So again, see here, we will discuss here, that is third part is R, that is bronchi, that is bronchi and bronchioles and bronchioles, bronchioles. So again here, bronchi and bronchioles. So the these bronchi are attached to the trachea. That's why trachea is divides into two parts. Divides into two parts. That two parts is, that is right and left part. Right and left part. So see here, this is a one part and this is another part. And both these two parts of the bronchi reach in a lungs portion. And this bronchi we will see here look like a C-shaped structure, and this C-shaped structure is a incomplete rings. These are a incomplete rings, and that whole bronchi again divides into two parts. That is again two parts. That is secondary and tertiary bronchi, and this leads to the terminal bronchioles. And he इकडे मग terminal bronchioles as a lead करतात, and then this leading is ending into the alveoli. So the first part is, that is right and left part मध्ये divide होत असतो, and this right and left part is, that is primary bronchi, primary bronchi, as it reaches the middle of thoracic cavity, middle of thoracic cavity. Then this bronchi is internally look like in a C shape. Internally look like a C shape, and rings is incomplete. This rings is incomplete. Rings of cartilage. Incomplete rings of cartilage. Then the bronchi again divides to form a secondary and tertiary bronchi, which leads to a terminal bronchioles, terminal bronchioles, and this terminal bronchioles is ending into alveoli, ending into alveoli. Okay, so this is the nature of bronchi and bronchioles. So the next part is, that is lungs. So again here, lungs is a most important organ of human respiratory system. So this important organ we found in a one pair of spongy and elastic lungs. We found in a spongy and elastic lungs. So the next part is that is lungs. Next part is a lung. It is a main respiratory organ. It is a one pair of spongy and elastic. Then again here, lungs enclosed and protected by double pleural membrane, outer parietal, inner visceral membrane. So see here, this is the outer layer of lungs. This is a outer layer of lungs, and this outer layer has a enclosed and protected by double pleura. So he ka hai pleura hai hi. He ka hai pleura, and this pleura is a double pleural membrane. Ka hai double pleural membrane. Outer parietal and inner. Outer parietal and inner visceral membrane. तर ह्या प्रोटेक्ट करतात कोणाला लंग्सला. तर ही आउटर पराइटल आणि ही इनर विसरल मेम्ब्रेन. बोथ दिस मेम्ब्रेन्स इज एनक्लोज्ड अँड प्रोटेक्टेड बाय अ लंग्स. लंग्सला ते काय करतात एनक्लोज करतात आणि प्रोटेक्टेड करतात. त्यासाठी प्रोटेक्शन साठी डबल लेअर्ड मेम्ब्रेन असते, अँड त्या डबल लेअर्ड मेम्ब्रेन मध्ये ही आउटर काय आहे पराइटल आणि ही इनर जी आहे ती विसरल मेम्ब्रेन आहे. तर बोथ दिस मेम्ब्रेन इज एनक्लोज्ड अँड प्रोटेक्टेड बाय द लंग्स. अँड इन बिटवीन दिस टू मेम्ब्रेन्स देअर इज अ लुब्रिकेटिंग फ्लूइड इज प्रेझेंट. देअर इज अ लुब्रिकेटिंग फ्लूइड इज प्रेझेंट अँड दिस फ्लूइड इज प्रेझेंट इन प्युरल कॅव्हिटी. सो दिस इज नोन ॲज प्युरल fluid. It means that between the two pleura, so between the two pleura, this is one and this is another. In between these two pleura, here is a pleural cavity is present, and this pleural cavity filled with a lubricating fluid. So the pleural cavity madhe lubricating fluid asto, and this lubricating fluid is known as pleural fluid. Okay, so again this lung, so again this lung has a right and left part. So the right part of the lung is larger and divides into three lobes, first, second and third. तर राईट जो लंग आहे तो डिवाइड करतो थ्री लोब मध्ये. व्हाईल इन लेफ्ट लंग इज स्मॉलर एज कम्पेअर टू द राईट अँड इट इज डिवाइड इन टू टू लोब आणि तो डिवाइड करतो दोन लोब मध्ये. ओके, सो दिस लंग इज एंटर द टर्मिनल ब्रँक्युअल्स अँड दिस टर्मिनल ब्रँक्युअल्स हॅज अ सॅप लाईक स्ट्रक्चर. And inside this sac-like structure, number of alveoli are present. This alveoli, we see the next part is that is alveoli. Next part is alveoli. So it is a thin walled lobulated structure like a bunch of grapes. So see here this is a sac structure, and in this sac structure here is a bunch of grapes like structure we will see here, and this bunch like structure is known as alveoli. So this is a alveoli. So each alveolus is surrounded by a net. आणि ह्या प्रत्येक अल्व्हिओलाईच्या सराउंडेड मध्ये नेटवर्क ऑफ कॅपिलरीज प्रेझेंट आहेत अँड दॅट नेटवर्क ऑफ कॅपिलरीज ऑफ दॅट इज पल्मोनरी आर्टरीज अँड वेन्स. ह्या कॅपिलरीजला अटॅच होतात किंवा इथून निघतात नंतर पल्मोनरी आर्टरीज आणि वेन्स. सो दिस अल्व्हिओलाई इज हायली इलास्टिक वॉल आणि ह्या कशा असतात हायली इलास्टिक वॉल मेड अप ऑफ अ सिंगल लेअर ऑफ स्क्वॅमस इपिथेलियम आणि सिंगल लेअरने ज्या बनलेल्या असतात त्या सिंगल लेअर इज नोन एज स्क्वॅमस इपिथेलियम. सो दिस स्क्वॅमस इपिथेलियम रेस्टिंग ऑन अ बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ कनेक्टिव्ह टिश्यू आणि ह्या बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन जी आहे त्या बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेनच्या कनेक्टिव्ह टिश्यूला ते काय आहे रेस्ट आहे. देन दिस अल्व्हिओलाय बी फाउंड इन अ 700 मिलियन इन द लंग्स. ह्या लंग्स मध्ये ज्या अल्व्हिओलाय असतात त्या जनरली किती असतात 700 मिलियन इन द लंग्स अँड दे प्रोव्हाइड आणि त्या हेल्प करतात दे प्रोव्हाइड द सर्फेस एरिया फॉर एक्सचेंज ऑफ गॅसेस आणि इट हेल्प फॉर द प्रोव्हाइडिंग अ सर्फेस एरिया फॉर द एक्सचेंज ऑफ गॅसेस. गॅसेस एक्सचेंज करण्यासाठी सर्फेस एरिया तर प्रोव्हाइड करतात. विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दिस प्रोव्हाइडिंग एरिया अ ह्युमन बीइंग रेस्पायर. ह्युमन बीइंग रेस्पायर. सो दिस इज अ नेचर अँड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अल्व्हिओलाय. सो इन बिलो द लंग्स हिअर इज अ अगेन वन पार्ट इज प्रेझेंट दॅट वन पार्ट इज नोन एज डायफ्राम. सो डायफ्राम इज सिच्युएटेड डायफ्राम इज सिच्युएटेड इन बिटवीन थोरॅसिक कॅव्हिटी अँड ऍबडॉमिनल कॅव्हिटी. सो नेक्स्ट पार्ट वी विल डिस्कस इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर.